Well, here at Grace Church, we've got one vision that God has given to us, and it is to partner with Him in transforming people from unbelievers to fully devoted disciples of Jesus, making sure that God gets all of the glory. And today, we are glad that we are going to be able to celebrate the baptism of Anna Sharamchevskiy. And she sat down with Pastor Kevin this week and shared her story. So turn your attention to the screen and watch this.
Some words to describe my life before this moment would definitely be lonely, confused, lost. I turned to people rather than God. Now finally God's my best friend. God didn't say life will be easy after you accept Him, but He promised that He will never leave your side. I actually got a tattoo that says it, and that I carried you that reflects my entire life up until now, because He has kept me under His wing. My life has been so much more positive and rewarding ever since I accepted His promise. And I have people coming up to me and telling me that they can see God in my eyes. And for the first time in my life, God is showing me that I am a person of worth. God has been helping me see things in a new way. I've been looking at the positives, doing kind things for others, and wanting to do everything for His glory. I first started coming to Grace Church last November when I moved here from Pennsylvania, and it really stuck out to me because I did my research and they're so involved with the community, Third Saturday Outreach, always doing something. The thing that stuck out to me was they're constantly connecting with you. I got involved with Jesus for Juveniles. It really caught my attention on the screen. All the troubled boys and girls, and I just really have a soft spot for that. Really love to be beneficial to them, be a person that they could see every Sunday and confide in, help them through their journey. If I was going to encourage anybody watching today that kind of felt like how I did, that they were lonely and felt like they didn't really have anybody and they could never be the perfect Christian, I encourage you to read the Bible, get involved in the church, get involved in your community, start serving others, take the first step, because it's never too late. God will change everything around. What prompted my decision was hearing the good news that I was a person of worth, and that I didn't have to be a perfect Christian to be a perfect daughter of God's. I desired to be baptized so that I could finally extend a hand to everybody else, so that I could help people, so that I could do the good work of God, so that my life will have meaning. It's so rewarding and gratifying. Jesus is my Lord and Savior. He's my best friend. He is everything. He's my Father.
Well, Anna, I had the great privilege of learning more of your story this week, and today I have the joy of asking you your baptism vows. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Do you truly and earnestly repent of your sins and accept Jesus Christ as your Savior? And if so, say, I do.
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, and in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life? If so, you say, I do.
I do.
Okay. Do you desire to be baptized today in the Christian faith? If so, say, I do.
I do.
Will you then obediently keep God's holy will and commandments and walk in the same all the days of your life? And if so, you say, I will.
I will.
All right.
All right, Anna, I want to invite you to hold your nose. All right. I want to invite you all to get ready for when she comes up out of the water. We need to join in celebrating together what God is doing in Anna's life. All right. Anna, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. down. We're going to pray for her. Come over here. All right. Everybody extend a hand and let's pray. God, we thank you for Anna. Lord, we thank you that today she is marked as a child of God and person of worth, that she is your daughter. And Lord, we thank you that you have called her to yourself. You have claimed her as your very own. That Lord, you have cleansed her by the waters of baptism. And that Lord, you are sending her out, commissioning her today to be a missionary for you in her everyday life. And Lord, for every day that she lives until she meets you face to face. Lord, we thank you for Jesus for Juveniles ministry that you stirred in her heart that day when she saw the need, not realizing, Lord, that you would meet her need as she went on mission for you. And God, we thank you for her life. We thank you for the way you've been working in her life. And we thank you, God, for the best is yet to come. And Lord, we praise you and thank you for who you are, that you're the God who transforms people from the inside out. And Lord, we pray that you would strengthen her today like never before. Encourage her, bless her, and keep her as we pray all of this in the powerful name of Jesus. Everybody agreeing with this prayer said,
Amen.
Once again, let's thank God for Anna today. And you may be seated.